when you heard that the Supreme Court ruled the way that it did in the Espinoza case, what was your reaction?
Well, I was thrilled and hopeful for those states that have restrictive Blaine amendments that really restricted the flow of money to religious private schools would now be given more ability to be able to do so. This has really been about those states, the 38 states that have Blaine amendments, that have always made it difficult for them to have school choice programs that include religious schools because of these restrictions. Now, there have been states, of course, that have found ways around their Blaine amendments or other types of non-aid amendments to private schools, private religious schools, but this really does open the door for expanded school choice in a lot of states that couldn't have it previously.
Now, as we mentioned in the conversation with Mike Long, North Carolina has not had one of these amendments. What sort of impact might it have for this state?
I don't think we'll see much of an impact in this state. It's good that we didn't have that barrier, and we haven't had that barrier to be able to have the private school scholarship programs that we have in North Carolina, and even the limited ones that we have. The one effect, the one long-term effect this may have is in public sentiment about private school scholarships for special needs, low income, or any other students that feel like they would be better served in a private school that has a religious focus. And so while we won't see any direct effect in North Carolina immediately or in the short term, I think we're going to see a general sentiment of acceptance of these kind of programs and perhaps an expansion of them in the future to accommodate this newfound acceptance of them.
Along with that, could there be a secondary effect of other states expanding choice? And so in North Carolina, we say, hey, you know, we better keep up. Or as people move into the state and they have programs in their states, they'll want North Carolina to keep up?
Absolutely. We're going to see that type of effect. But of course, those are long-term effects. And so I think once we do see just a general acceptance that these are good programs, as more and more students graduate and testify to the positive effects of private school scholarships for religious institutions, and perhaps have kids of their own, I think that's really going to be the long-term effect of this, and hopefully that effect makes its way here to North Carolina, because there are a lot of families out there that would love to have the opportunity to attend a private religious institution but can't because they don't have the resources to do so.
As a reminder, from a broader perspective, this idea of expanding school choice is designed to make things better for all students, the ones who take advantage of choice and also the ones who stick with the traditional district schools, right?
That's right. This is really about meeting the needs of individual students, and it's really hard to do that when you have a one-size-fits-all system. So the whole idea, the whole philosophy behind school choice is to provide as many different options, many different opportunities for children, for them to be able to seek out those opportunities and find a school that has the instructional approach, the curriculum, the standards that they can really thrive in. Because as we know, not every child thrives in our public system that is mainly offers one type of curriculum, one type of standards, and one type of instructional approach.
You talk to people in all facets of education. Are the ones who are supporters of choice really excited about this Espinoza ruling?
They are. They absolutely are. And they've been looking forward to the demise of these Blaine amendments for many years. And really, the kudos goes to the Institute for Justice and the plaintiffs in this case, who really fought hard to ensure that finally we can start putting an end to the Blaine amendments, which had always been rooted in anti-Catholic bigotry in the 19th century. Because even looking beyond school choice, the Blaine amendments were always an evil part of governance and of our history. And so if we can start getting rid of Blaine amendments that, as I said, were rooted in anti-Catholic bigotry, that would go a long way to creating systems of education that treat all schools as equals.